Statements by ministries. Responses. The member from Lanark-Frontenac, Lennox and Addington.
Thank you, Speaker. And I guess before I start in my address on this Ontario Forest Tenure Review, Tenure Modernization Act, I will commend the minister for and his ministry for providing a briefing on this bill before it was introduced into the bill, into the House. But I will say, for 2 years now, we've been under this forest tenure review. 2 years of uncertainty in our forestry sector, 2 years of bleakness in our forestry, the years when we've seen our over 60 mills closed, over 40,000 jobs lost, and in 2 years' time, we have received this bill, which is really nothing more than an empty vessel. It's 16 pages which really provide nothing other than a backtrack, one more backtrack by this Liberal government in their obligations to the North and to our forestry. It does do a couple things, this bill. We do know in those 16 pages there is a few things that it does do. It does provide another vehicle for political patronage. It does create additional agencies of the Liberal government called forestry management corporations, local forestry management. These are additional agencies. If we don't have enough already, we already have over 600 agency boards and commissions in this province, but we're going to create a few more with this bill. And what we have seen with these agency boards and commissions, like the LINs, we've seen a very significant, very purposeful method of them of shielding the government from the decisions of the day. And as we have seen with the LINs, we are now seeing, I guess, what we would call the forestry LINs or the FLINs are now being created by this Liberal government. But I think there is also very much important within this bill, there are a couple very significant components, Speaker. Significant components, the changes to the Crown Forestry Sustainability Act. Now, of course, we won't know what is all going to happen because there aren't any regulations, very few. Everything is going to be done by regulation afterwards in this bill. And I don't know how many more years the forestry industry is going to have to suffer and wait for the regulations to be done on this. But under the changes of the Crown Forest Sustainability Act, the minister now has the ability to arbitrarily cancel licenses, has the authority to cancel supplies, and in an arbitrary fashion, leave the people in our forestry industry once again with uncertainty of their future, uncertainty of their supplies. And that starts on page 13 of this act. But what also is significant in this act, significant protection for the ministry, significant protection for the minister, significant protection for the local forestry management corporations, that whatever they do, there can be no liability, no remedy attached to those agents of the Crown. And that goes from page 14 through page 16 of this Act, where limitations on remedies, no remedies, proceedings barred, no expropriation or injurious affection, exception, the Crown leaves itself harmless from any of its actions, but puts 3 or 4 more years of uncertainty into already a very devastated resource sector of this province. So I'm very disappointed that in 2 years' time, this Liberal government has achieved absolutely nothing except one more backtrack and one more slap to the people of Northern Ontario, and that this Liberal government manages to pass the buck once more as they try to pass a bill. These are not really bills that are being introduced in this House. They're just looking to pass the buck, not bills. Thank you very much.